Okay, so what's up? Good morning, everyone.
Morning, Rabbi Leitner.
Yishar Koach, Martin, as well. Okay, so on Friday we began to look at the analysis that Rabbi Weiss gave of davening together when it's less than a minyan, and the final case which he cited is, I think, for our purposes, the most significant one. It's a case in the Gemara. Also in Masechet Sota, which just to remind you that there were people who were doing Shmirat HaMeit, Vachen, for a body, but it was on a ship. And they left the body and then went to a corner and davened together, the two of them, rather than one staying with the body and the other one going to daven and then switching roles. So the Gemara debates this question, and Rabbi Weiss, in his analysis of it, brings two reasons, which are from earlier sources, to why this could be the case. The first is that the main reason for looking after a body is to make sure that it's nothing untoward happens to it before burial. Since they were on a ship and the circumstances were such that they didn't have to worry about what was going on, they felt they could leave it. And that's analogous in some ways to what happens today very regularly when Shmirah is done by the fact that the body is being kept in a properly supervised mortuary. The second reason is that to avoid any damage from, say, rodents or something similar, which might want to attack the body and before burial. And given they were on a ship, there was no concern, says Gemara, in this case, about there being any rodents. And therefore, the two of them went to daven together in one corner. Rabbi says, but despite this, what was the benefit of them davening together? Nonetheless, surely it would have been better for one to stay with the body and the other to go and daven. So to answer this, he quotes a very fascinating view of the Maharam Bennett, Rabbi Mordechai Bennett, who was one of the great Rabbanim of Germany, particularly in the 19th century, between the 18th and 19th centuries, well known especially for his role in the development of modern copyright law in Halacha, after the Rödelheim Machzorim were published, which was perhaps the first modern Machzorim, with notes and translations, etc., and some of the editions like the Rödelheim Siddur. He was one of the leading poskim of the time who developed the modern concepts of copyright law in Judaism, with particular relevance to this, those machzorim, because there were others who wanted to print them other than the original publisher who'd done all the work to get them printed. There were others who thought, no, this is part of the heritage of the Jewish people, and we can print them anyway, despite the fact the original publisher had put much time and money into publishing it. That's a topic we'll look at another time. But Rabbi Bennett, when discussing this Gemara, says something which Rabbi Weiss says is a tremendous chidush, like a really new idea. And he says that the basic pasuk, which we've been using, the verse from Iyov, which talks about the power of communal prayer, Hein El Kaviv, Lo Yimas Tefilat Rabim, that God does not despise Tefilat Rabim. God is a powerful God, does not despise Tefilat Rabim, the prayer of the multitudes. Rabbi Bennett says that doesn't just refer to a minyan. We've got other sources, as we've learned, which refer to a minyan and the making of a minyan. So therefore, Tefillah Rabbim has to be something different. And that doesn't have to even be Tefillah B'tzibur, a communal prayer, in the regular ways we'll see in Rabbi Weiss's next essay, Will Being Well, which is davening of the Amidah together. But it can be any number of people davening together. So Rabbi Weiss says, given that Rabbi Bennett is one of the great authorities of his time, Rabbi Weiss applies the phraseology Gadol miRabban Shemo, greater than a rabbinic title is his name, which fascinatingly was applied Lehavdil ben Chaim L'Chaim by Rabbi Nachum Rabinovich to Rabbi Sachs, Aleihem HaShalom, at the time of Rabbi Sachs's retirement. It's a way of saying that someone is such a great rabbi that their name, in a sense, transcends any title they have. And Rabbi Weiss says, since the Maharam Bennett was one of the great students and transmitters of Torah, one of the great teachers and transmitters of Torah in this generation, Rabbi Weiss says, even though I disagree with him on this particular point, my opinion is nullified in the face of his opinion. And so, therefore, if people are wanting to govern together, even if it's one or two people together, family members, doesn't matter, want to govern together, they can do so obviously safely and legally, they should do that, and there is a power to that. And by extension, we can suggest there is therefore a power to what we're doing on Zoom. Somehow we are fulfilling, at least according to the view of the Maharam Bennett, this pasuk in Iyov that says that tefillat rabim is at least more than one person. And even if we can't at home, perhaps at home some can daven with others at the same time, but not everybody can. But even at least by Zoom, we can do that, and we get some form of tefillat rabim rather than just davening by ourselves. So I think it's, first of all, a very fascinating response, and as ever, by Rabbi Weiss, not just in the information he brings, but methodologically, how he analyzes the question. And of course, his conclusion is that which is something which has an enormous amount for everyone to learn from, far beyond the just the question of tefillat rabim. Have a great day in Shavuot Tov.
Shavuot Tov.